Hello, 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 my little cookies. It's a girl here, Kit. Listen, I'm gonna make this intro a bit short, because I normally make intros a bit long, but you know. So this is gonna be part Steven of Jax X Listener, where he makes it up to you, because if you haven't watched part 6, then go ahead and watch it before you watch part 7. So basically, Caine and Bubbles wanted to stalk on you guys while you guys were on your picnic date, and it went terribly wrong, so he wanted to make it up to you, so, yeah, also my throat kind of hurts, so, this is a request from one of my cookies, so thank you for the request, I will gladly do it, so, yeah, and I will make a Jack, and this will be a Jack X Listener series, so, yeah, anyways, also, I thought a good idea for, like, I'm making things awkwarder. Anyways, further ado, I will get started with this part 7 of Jack X Listener. Where Jack makes it up. Fuck, I can't speak English. Let me do that again. This is part 7 of Jack X Listener, where he makes it up to you. There. I said it. My English is terrible today. So, Jack is with, Pomini and, Ragatha and, Gangle. So, yeah, let's just get started. Gangle. How many times are you gonna keep on finding comedy mask?
But a lot, because my comedy mask keep on breaking.
Oh, if you like, Angle, we can make you a new comedy mask.
That would be so sweet,
Pomini, but these comedy masks are really complicated to make. Well, we could be judge of that. We can help you find some in your room. If not, we can, you know.
Okay.
Hey guys.
Oh, hey Jack. How's it going?
Good.
Okay, that's good. What are you doing?
I thought you were gonna, you know, go, do what you normally do, like prank someone. I was going to, but yeah.
Jack, are you okay? You kind of look a little bit yin now.
Yeah. What do you mean, Ragatha?
I don't know. Can you please tell us what's up? Because you're not acting like yourself.
Have you seen Listener?
She's in her room sleeping. Why do you ask?
So you know the picnic date yesterday?
Yeah, I thought that went pretty well.
It did the first part was good, but, it was going pretty well until Caine and Bubbles, were stalking us, so, you know.
True.
And, well, I really gotta get revenge for that. Really good get payback for that. But not today, because, you know. So, yeah. I just wanna make it up to Listener.
You don't need to make it up to them, Jack.
I do. I wanted it to make it perfect and all, but Caine had to ruin it all. Had to ruin it, and, well, Bubbles too, so, you know.
Well, if you like, we can help you with that, Jack. We can help you make something for her and, you know.
No, Gangle, it's fine. Besides, I heard that you need to help Gangle find her mask, you know.
Have you heard how, you know, how, what's the word? Are you hearing our conversation, Jack?
Maybe. Perhaps. I don't know.
Sorry, I had to, change the music, so yeah. Anyways, let's continue.
I may or may not heard you guys' conversation, show you.
Oh, okay, interesting. Well, yeah, so if you're looking for them, she's in her room. Cool, thanks. So, Gangle, do you need help with finding your mask?
Yeah.
Sorry about that. That was just my neighbor. Anyways, let's continue.
Yeah, okay. You guys can help me.
Okay, Pyme, do you want to come help me find a comedy mask with Gangle?
I mean, I got nothing else to do, so sure.
All right, well, let's go. So, Jack went to the hallway, and Gina went to go up to room until all of a sudden he saw, Caine.
Oh, hello, Jack.
Oh, Caine. Yeah, what are you doing? I thought you were in your pillow fort.
Oh, yes, I was going to get some more pillows out of my room so that way I can make it a bit big, because you know what those,
weird blocks are like.
Oh, yeah, that. So, what are you doing, Jack?
Gonna go see Listener.
What? Why are you gonna go see them?
About yesterday. I wanted to make it up to them.
Oh, I see. So, you wanna make it up for that?
Yeah, cause, you know, Caine and Bubbles ruined it, and I wanted it to be perfect.
Jack, doesn't need to be perfect. You know that, buddy.
I know, but I just want it to be good, you know, cause I never been Look, I've never been on a date before, and, you know, now that we're stuck in this digital, logical, frickin' place and all, and, you know.
Yes, even though I've been here the longest, and yet I still remember my wife, my queen, my everything.
Okay, don't get lovey-dovey already, okay? Sheesh.
Okay, well, I'll see you later, Jack.
Or see you, Caine. So, Jack went up to your door and, yeah, knocked. And, yeah, you were in your room sleeping, so yeah.
Alright. There's nothing.
Listener, you in there?
Listener?
Maybe I should knock again?
You were in there?
Oh, fuck. Please, no. Please, no. Please, no. Please, wait, Jack. Please, wait, Jack. Please don't. Also, I forgot to say, like, in the first part, there's a character, I'm just gonna put, like, a new, character in it. So, his name is, Blubble, and he's like Bubbles, but, like, he's, like, a slime, so, yeah. He's, one of Caine's best friends, so, yeah. Don't worry, none of the characters in this, were abstract. Bubbles got abstract, so, yeah, ever since you came, none of them abstract, so, so, Blubble, got abstract, and, well, completely weird saying, so, you know, anyway, sorry about that, let's continue. So, Jack opened the door, and he noticed that you were asleep.
Listener?
Oh, they're asleep. They're so cute. Hugging their adorable little plushie. So he, like, closed the door and, like, gently, he closed the door slowly so that way he didn't wake you up, because, you know, he knows what you're like when you are awoke. Yeah, so yeah. So he walked up further to your bed and sat down next to you and, like, put his hand on your, head and just started, like, playing with your hair. And, yeah. Also, hi, narrator here! Sorry for interrupting. I'm gonna go now.
Your hair's so soft. You look so peaceful when you sleep, Listener.
Oh, shit. Hey, love. Sorry, I didn't mean to wake you up.
What am I here?
Well, I just wanted to see how you're doing. How'd I got in? Well, I knocked. But it was locked. Oh, well, I knew it was locked, so I had the key, so you know. Yeah, I have the keys everywhere, doll. But anyways, one of these keys is probably the escape to get the hell out of here.
What? I said nothing. Anyways,
so how are you?
Good. That's good. That's good.
Oh, I'm here. So, you know about yesterday?
Yeah, well, about that, I'm really sorry.
No, it's my fault. I wanted to
be perfect and, you know, but Caine and Bubbles ruined it. So, the reason why I'm here is because, look, doll, I want to make it up to you, okay? Yeah. I want to make it up to you, okay? Yeah, about what happened, so, you know. Yeah. But anyways. Look, like I said, I'm really sorry, doll. You forgive me? Are you sure? you're so sweet, doll. So they just, laid back and just, put his head on your lap. I know, but look. The reason why none of us haven't got abstract yet is because, well, you know, none of us went completely insane. But the reason why I haven't went abstract and completely insane like Cabo did, it's because, well, you're here and you're always there for me, doll, and for the others. So I'm happy that you're here. I mean, ever since you came here and all, nobody got abstract. I think. I don't know. But, you know. But, yeah. So, like I'm saying, is that I want to make it up to you for what happened yesterday. Yeah. Oh, actually, another reason why I'm here is because, well, I thought of a new nickname. Yeah, Remember yesterday I said that I was gonna think of a nickname for you, you know, instead of calling you doll and that. What's wrong with calling you doll? I mean, well, calling you doll is like a pretty basic nickname, so I just want to call you something, you know, that we can agree on, if you know what I mean. Yeah. Let's see. Why not? Oh, actually, I thought of one. How does Little Rose sound to you? Why Little Rose? Well, because, well, you're pretty, you're sweet, you're nice, and you're hot. Come on, don't hide your face. Come on, don't hide your face.
So, how does Little Rose sound? If you don't like it, then I can pick up another one. Oh, you like it? That's good. What? What a rose it is. Kiss on the forehead. So, what do you want to do? Yeah, I know. I was going to prank someone today, but I really don't feel like it. I know. The reason why I do that is because, well, yeah. I do pranks not so that way I don't get abstract, you know, and not to get crazy. Though ever since Paimi came here, she kind of went insane and crazy and all, but she went abstract, so I'm really glad for that. But yeah. So we can just relax and, you know? So, yeah. How does that sound, Rose? My little Rose. That's good. We can have the whole day to ourselves. Just you and me. Come here. So he just picked you up and put you on his lap and just cuddled you and, you know, giving you little kisses on the on the cheek. What? You it when I do that, little Rose. Maybe if I kiss you on the neck like this. Okay. That tickles. Well, at least I know where a tickle spot is. Listener, did you invite someone else? You didn't? Oh, come in.
Hey, Jack. We may have a problem.
What's wrong, Ragatha?
You know Blubble, right?
Who?
You know that slime that came, that was here when ever, look, he was here and you know, okay, just spit it out. Just spit it out, Ragdoll.
Okay, so, look, ever since Listener came, Blubble's been acting a bit strange, and he hasn't been coming out of his room. And, well, as you can see, he's abstract.
Wait, what?
Yeah, he went completely insane, and, you know.
Well, where the hell is Caine?
Caine is at a restaurant.
Are you fucking serious?
No, I am not serious.
Come on, Listener.
Also, what were you two doing?
Oh, you don't need to know.
Okay.
So, where's Blubbo?
He's in his room.
He hasn't been coming out for weeks. Months! I see. Well, don't worry, guys. I have his key.
Jack! You shouldn't be having a key to anyone's room.
What? It's completely fine, and trust me. If you always needed your key, you can always just come ask. Also, I may have found something in your room, Ragatha, that I needed. So I hope you're not afraid of centipedes, are you?
Jack, that is my only one weakness. Why would you do that?
What? It's completely normal.
Besides, you might never know what's going on in there. That room of yours. Besides, also, do not distract them, okay? They're having a party.
Oh, but what?
I see. Oh, shit. So when Jack, like, opened the door, like, well, unlocked the door, and he opened it slowly, and Blubbo was just right there, distracted, and yeah.
Oh, fuck. See what I mean, Jack? He went abstracted.
There's so many. Why?
Oh, fuck.
Okay, how about this? You, me, and Pymie, and Listener will go deal with Blubbo, which leaves Crybaby, and Hoo-Ha, and Zobo to go find Caine.
Are you sure that's a good idea to team those guys up?
Of course. They're the most utterly stable, well, people ever, so, you know. So, do you think you guys can do that?
I guess so.
Well, yes we can, Jack. We can do that. I really don't want to.
This is blah what we're talking about. This is Caine's best friend. If we don't do anything, then we're all doomed. And trust me, we do not want to be abstract like him and the others.
Damn, Ragatha, we never expect you to be really bossy.
Well, I'm sorry. So, come on. Will you help us?
Fine.
Thank you. So you're afraid go find Caine, we'll deal with him.
Alright.
Alright, go now!
You sure this is a good idea?
Trust me, I'm pretty much sure he'll...
Watch out!
So Blubbo just like came out of his room and just like was about to pound. He like hit the wall and then he saw you and then was running towards you.
Listener!
Shit!
So Jack like ran over to you and then like... pushed you out of the way, and, yeah.
And, of course,
he was on top of you.
Fuck, that was close. You okay, Listener? Okay, that's good.
He's getting away, you guys!
Fuck. Go deal with him, now.
But what about you two?
Don't worry, we'll be fine, okay?
Okay.
You okay, Listener? He didn't hurt you, did he? Oh, thank God. Yes, I'm fucking worried. Sorry. Look, I just don't want to lose you, okay? You're the only thing that is keeping me not going crazy and abstract, you know? Look, I care about you so much, Listener. And I'm not fucking losing you. Got that? Come on. Let's go help the others.
So, meanwhile, with Caine and Bubbles.
You know, this is a nice place to go. Thank you for inviting me, Caine.
You're
perhaps will be welcome. Hmm? What's this? Oh! My wacky watch is going off! What?
Is something the matter, Caine?
I'll be right back, Bubbles. I'll be right back.
But what about me, Caine?
Oh, you're right. Come on, Bubbles. Get into my hat.
Okay. Caine, where are you?
Where the tarnation could Caine be?
I don't know.
He was going to a restaurant, was he? Holy shit! Okay, what seems to be the problem?
It's Bubble, human abstract.
Yes! Rekafo was just gonna go check up on him, and so all of a sudden, he went abstract. Oh, God. Where is he? Wait, where's Jack and Listener?
They're with Rekafo and Piney.
Oh, shoot. Come on, show me where they are.
Okay.
Come on, let's go. Piney, what are you doing?
Nothing, Jack.
Come on. No time. Let's go.
Oh. You guys, he's over here.
Thanks. Caine.
Caine, thank goodness you're here.
Blobbo is abstracted? Jesus Christ.
Oh, guess you guys told him? Yeah, they told him.
What is the Listener? Oh, shoot. Whoa.
Blobbo, is that you? Caine, don't get any close!
Blobbo, what happened to you?
I'm so sorry, Blobbo. But you must go to the... where the others are.
Is Caine gonna be okay, you guys?
Maybe we can leave him alone for a bit.
Yeah. Huh? I'm fine, Listener. Don't worry, I'm... Huh?
Wow, I would actually never expect Listener to calm down Caine that quickly.
Yeah.
I gotta say, Jack, you must be a really lucky guy to be dating someone like her. Jack?
I'm the fucking luckiest man in the world.
Okay.
So, after when you, calmed Caine down, everything was back to normal. Well, except for Blobbo and, along with the others, so, yeah. What for you and Jack?
Man, today was a craziest day, am I right?
Yeah. I would actually never expect you to calm Caine down that quickly.
Yeah. But, I gotta say, I must be, the luckiest man ever.
Come here.
Come on. Why don't we go back to my room and watch a movie, okay? Today's been a rough day, am I right?
Come on, let's go.
So he, picked you up and he took you to his room and, closed the door and puts you on his bed gently. He put you on the bed gently. It wasn't, he didn't yeet you on the bed.
But yeah, it's a hide narrator here again. But yeah, I'm going now. Again. For my, coffee break. Bye, guys.
Alright. You want to break the movie or do... Oh, you want me to pick the movie? Are you sure? You're so sweet, Listener. Why don't we watch this one? And we all will watch this one. Alright. Beetlejuice it is. I love you too, babe. Come on. Come over here. I want to cuddle. Please. Babe, you know I hate saying please, my manners, and of course apologizing, but if it's you, then
Come here. Love you, babe. Okay, let's watch this movie then. You want pop? Okay. I guess no popcorn. Alright. I love you too, babe. Alright, let's watch the movie then, shall we? Alright. What a day. Yep, honestly, I feel pretty fucking shit. What? I'm just saying. This feels nice. I feel like, why do I have a feeling that I'm with Dreamwatch?
Hello, Jack and listener.
Yo, what the